Unless you've been living under a rock, you may have heard about potentially one of the most exciting collaborations in the past few years in the guitar community between Ernie Ball Music Man and modern guitar god Tosin Abasi. This is the Kaizen. Tosin Abasi, of course, changing the landscape and continuing to change the landscape of modern guitar. He's basically your favourite guitarist's guitarist. It's important to say that the Kaizen isn't a signature model, although Tosin Abasi does play one live and in the studio and has very much put his name to this. It is very much a collaborative effort kind of on both sides of, you know, Ernie Ball Music Man and Tosin Abasi to really push the boundaries on what kind of a modern genre fluid guitar can really do. The first thing that we'll touch on, of course, is the Kaizen's unique shape. Now, this may put some people off, it may be incredibly appealing to some, but for those people that are potentially on the fence, within 5 minutes of playing this body shape, it does really start to make sense why it's kind of shaped like this. It's an incredibly contoured body that me and actually my colleague Aaron, who's filming this, and several other colleagues in the company, I think this may be the comfiest guitar that some of us have ever played. Think of it kind of in the same sort of wheelhouse as a Strandberg. You know, it just feels incredibly effortless. Like, you don't need to fight against it. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't fall off you. It just sits absolutely perfectly with your body. It's also incredibly light as well, which I think is incredibly important with modern guitars, and certainly for anybody who, you know, plays long gigs or just sits in a studio for a while, you know, that can really start to kind of wear away on your leg or your shoulder, so the Kaizen gets plus points for that. It has a 5-bolt-on neck design here, and of course you can see more of those contours on the back of the body and into the neck there, so you can really get up to the dusty end kind of with no restrictions from the body itself. This large plastic back panel as well is how you get into the controls and the trem cavity. A thing that I think is quite smart about this is that it's almost like a big protector for, you know, against kind of your belt or any buckles or anything like that. It's a really, really smart design that I think they put into this. It's loaded with 2 Music Man heat treated pickups. Now, in the bridge there is a kind of more modern, relatively middle to high gain humbucker. And in the neck, it's actually this offset mini humbucker, which is quite a sort of unique setup for, you know, a modern metal guitar. But that's one of the sort of combinations and parts of it that I think really pushes it out of that stereotype of it being just a metal guitar, which we'll demonstrate obviously in our sound demos as well, with some cleans and more kind of like pushed crunchy sounds as well. Master volume and a master tone, not much to get into other than the fact that these feel really, really smooth, and they've actually got a bit of grip around the sides there as well as them being obviously kind of flatter sort of tops on there, which I think just adds to the sort of futuristic design of it, and a 3-way selector, which this sort of indented into the body is also a nice feature. It makes it look sleek and a bit more futuristic. It's the usual configuration as well, with the pickup selector pointing towards the base of the body being the bridge, up towards the neck being the neck pickup. The middle position is quite unique with the Kaizen because it doesn't actually combine all of the coils of the pickups. What it is set to is actually the 2 outside coils of each humbucker, which gives you more of that sort of in-between sort of S-type sound that, I mean, Tosin Abasi uses a lot, and it does, again, just add to the sort of tonal fluidity that this guitar can really handle. Loaded with a Music Man custom multi-scale bridge, which I'll touch on a little bit. It's worth noting that it is flush to the body here, so you can't actually pull back on it. It's loaded with the usual Music Man truss rod wheel at the base of the neck, which for anybody who's used this, you'll know how amazing this is for any sort of setup on your guitar. As I'd mentioned earlier, the Kaizen is a multi-scale design. For anybody who was not quite sure what that means. Essentially what it means is that the bass side here is actually a slightly longer scale length of 25.5 inches, whereas the treble side there is slightly shorter at the 24.75 inch. Meaning a tight response when you're chugging on the low end and then slightly looser feel on the high strings for, you know, when you want to do bends or solos. It's a really, really good feature that doesn't take too long to actually get used to. Along with these 24 stainless steel fan frets that are on an ebony board, the radius is incredibly unique with this guitar and it's super, super, super flat. What you would expect if you've played, say, a Strat or a Tele that's maybe got a slightly more vintage feel to it, it does almost have kind of a rounder sort of feel to this, whereas the Kaizen, it has what they call the infinite radius. What this accomplishes is actually you can see the entire fretboard. Now that's a real funny sort of notion, because I imagine everyone watching this video right now who hasn't played one of these is going, well, I see my fretboard all the time. But if you play this and then immediately go to a guitar that you're more familiar with, you'll immediately notice what I'm talking about. It's not something that's gonna, you know, completely revolutionize your playing, but for me certainly, sitting with it for a bit, it just added to that sort of effortlessness that comes with this guitar. I didn't need to focus as hard as I usually do, certainly on like the sides where the dots are, because I could just see everything. Let's get a bit of appreciation for the back of this neck as well, with this absolutely gorgeous roasted maple with, it's actually got a lot of bird's eye in it, this one. And of course, is a super smooth matte finish as well. It's definitely been finished with some sort of oil on this. It just is an absolute pleasure to play. It's worth noting that the Kaizen does come in a 7-string variation as well, which is sporting a 25.65 inch radius for that extra low B. Finally, because you've been so patient, we will get to the sounds just in a second, but we have the usual 4 and 2 Ernie Ball Music Man setup on the headstock there, with actually a slightly different sort of ending there, which I think does set it apart from the other models too. And then these futuristic Steinberger locking tuners, which really add to this guitar's kind of futuristic look, but more importantly, keeps your tuning absolutely rock solid, especially with this tremolo arm as well. Let's get on to the sounds. Just before we do, we're running all of the sounds through our Line 6 Helix floor today. We've got a metal setting with the Line 6 Bedonk. We have a kind of clean ambient setting, which is just a standard Fender with a bit of reverse delay. And I've got a bit of a pushed Marshall sound as well. So we get kind of a full spectrum of what this guitar can do.
Thank you.
after spending a little bit of time with the Kaizen, what started as me expecting to play just kind of metal riffs on this and just go to absolute town with that style of music, has kind of morphed itself into me really appreciating this guitar for what it can do. Yes, it's a high octane machine that will be able to handle the highest of gains and the lowest of tunings and all the sounds in between, but it's those moments of real kind of nuance that makes this guitar shine, especially with that mini humbucker and that in-between sound. That's, you know, it's incredibly fluid, as I've mentioned a few times, especially if you're needing something incredibly reliable for on the road or even just in the studio. You know, you just, the main guitar that you go to pick up that covers every bass, and you know it's going to be absolutely perfect every time. But what do you think? Is this the future of guitar design right here, or should this have been left on the design table? Please let us know just down in the comments, and of course like and subscribe, all the usual stuff that YouTube people tell you. Do let us know down in the comments what you would like to see in terms of demos or gear explanations or anything as well. We're all ears and we're always willing to listen to suggestions. But until then, this is the Ernie Ball Music Man Kaizen, and I've been Keiran. Have a great day.